गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, माई सेल्फ राजेश डिक्लोज, वेलकम टू द ई लर्निंग क्लासेस प्रोवाइडेड बाई सेंट माइकल्स अकेडमी बेतिया। चिल्ड्रेन, वी आर हैविंग हिस्ट्री स्टैंडर्ड ए चैप्टर टू, टॉपिक रूलर लाइफ एंड सोसाइटी। एंड ऑलरेडी वी हैव टॉक एंड वी शो दैट व्हेन ब्रिटिश कॉलोनाइज्ड इंडिया टू एडमिन to meet the expenses of the administration, they wanted expenditure money. So they thought of to increase the revenue. To get the revenue, they tried so many policies so that they can get the revenue and they can meet their expenditure. So already we have talked about the Nadi settlements, which was introduced by Warren Hastings. Then we talked about the permanent settlements, which was used by Lord Cornwallis. And today we'll see about Rotwari settlements. These Rotwari settlements were introduced by Sir Thomas Munro. In this policies, government tried to take the revenue direct from the peasants. This is called Rotwari settlements. It was introduced in Madras Presidency and later extended to the Bombay Presidency as well. The revenue was taxed. Half of the product was given to the British. And sometimes there is no production, sometimes there is famine, sometimes there is a certain type of crisis, climatic problems. Because of that, there was scarcity of the revenue. So British could not get much benefits. Then they introduced the next policies, that is called Malabari settlements. It was introduced in 1830. This system was introduced in western Uttar Pradesh, part of Madhya Pradesh and Punjab. Under this system, the land revenue settlement was made for the entire states or Mahal. The responsibility of the collecting the revenue was given to the head of the village. The talukdar or the head of the village had to collect the revenue. In this system also, the revenue was fixed. Whatever products was there, half of the produce was given to the village head. This also did not benefit to the British, and because of that, some of the regions, it made a very bad effect on the peasants. What effect was made because of these policies? First, land became saleable. They took the loan from the money lender and paid the revenue. So at the last, either they had to sell the land or the land was taken by the money lender. Next effect was that most of the people became beggari or the bonded labor. Next effect was that agriculture continued to be stagnant. There was no any attempt to be taken to produce the agriculture, either by the British or the revenue collectors. Next effect was that the self-sufficiency of the villages was destroyed. And the last, because of the famines continued to be the regular feature as the land productivity failed. Chile, now plantation farming, cash crops. Now the British saw that there is no great benefits in the collecting of the revenue, then they thought of to have प्लांटेशन plantation farming cash crops. Now it is thought of to hire cash crops. They started and promoted the agriculture to grow cash crops like tea, coffee, indigo, jute, oilseed, sugarcane, mulberry, opium, rubber, etc. And these cash crops was most of the raw material for the British industries. So, agriculture, so farmers were very upset from the British and they became angry and they revolted against the British. Later on, the peasant revolt took place because of the not wanting the doing such a cash crops which was not beneficial for the farmers. It was beneficial for the British and for the industries of the Britain. Also, British forced the farmers to grow indigo. The word indigo is derived from the Greek word indicon and the Latin word indicum, meaning from India. Indigo was a natural blue dye used for a coloring cloth. So British forced the farmers to grow indigo. It is a blue dye. This made the farmers worse. Their condition became very poor and land also went on a very worse condition, because when the indigo is grown in the land, the soil becomes unfertile and again there is no more crops can be grown which are required by the farmers. And because of that, there was revolt between the peasants and the British. So impact of the peasants' revolt. Peasants' movement or rights did not create any threat to the British rule, but proved that the Indian peasants' reactions were impulsive and spontaneous to such situations and not planned. Second, their faith, courage, heroism and the willingness to make immense sacrifice were no match against the imperialist power armed with the latest weapons and the resources of the world. Again, the last, in addition, when the news of revolt outbreak and the British colonial powers miracles handing of a such revolt reached the outside world, the real intent and interest of the British were exposed. So, when the British forced the farmers to grow the indigo and the farmers reacted and the revolt took place between them, it was spread all over the world and the people criticized the action of the British. Okay, children. So, I will stop here today. This is the end of the lessons. Again, in the next video, we will meet with the question answers. Your homework is to do the objectives and come so that you can match the answers when I say. Okay, children. So, subscribe my channel and share it. Thank you very much.